is Mr. Van's Group TV. Today, we will talk about traffic after work. Traffic after work is different from traffic in the morning. Now, we are about to get in to Highway 40, that is the Trans-Canadian Highway 40. It is 3 to 4 o'clock in the afternoon, which means that everybody is going home from work or from school or whatever that they do. Now, I am heading west, which means that the traffic is going through the Trans-Canadian Highway. If I will continue, I would be able to reach Ottawa, Toronto, and if I will still continue to the west, I'll end up in Vancouver, Canada. This is where the Trans-Canadian Highway heading west is going. But now, I will just travel about 35 kilometers going home. I just want to show you how the traffic is going on in this part of the Trans-Canadian Highway. This part is the Montreal area.
Highway. It's the same as the other side.
kinds of people on our highways and our streets, anywhere in our world. But then again, we don't have to be angry when someone passes us or someone cut us. I have said, there is always one road to get home. In the afternoon is to get home safely, and that is a good goal. We came from our work, and we spend about 8 hours in there. To get home as fast as possible and have our rest of the day. But then, in order to get home safely, we must have to get home safely. Slow down and don't get angry, because getting angry on our roads doesn't help you on anything. In fact, it will only put you in trouble. And getting in trouble has more repercussions rather than just keep your cool and be patient. On our roads, anywhere in our world, just be cool and keep them the way. It happens all the time, because there were some drivers who think they are smart. We are always there. We knew what's going on. For example, in here, this is a 3-lane highway. But in this area, it will merge, so it will become 2. So I take this one and I will cut off. But the truckers, as I observe, I've been running in this highway for the last 6 months. The truckers, they're smart and they knew the road. These truck drivers, you see the truck drivers in front? He took it. So he will slow down, us small cars will slow down, so that the lane on my left will move. That's what they do, because this third lane will merge at the second lane. So just like this. But if they you will slow down on the third lane. That's what they are doing, and I like it, because that way both lanes will move. Otherwise, only the third lane, in which it will merge to the second lane, is moving. So that is green, doing by the truck drivers. They will make the second lane where the trucks are, so that it will move. Moving, but it is very slow, and most of the time at this rush hour cars on this area move as slow as this one. 66. Going south. On Route 15. 5, they are all running at 100 kilometers per hour. That's a constant speed for them. Same as the truckers. Because they need to reach their destination. But me, I'm going home. So, I just have to give way and be safe. We must have to be a defensive driver. Look at our back also, our front and our side. Someone is there moving too fast, and you don't want to move too fast, then you go to the slower lane. But please, you solve the problem. What should be the thing you should do? They are too fast, and there's no way for you to go anywhere. Then move a little bit fast until will get something. It's a free space for you to go this morning. That's what I call a defensive driver. You have to be flexible so that you can synchronize with the speed of the group of cars. MrVanSSGroupTV.